The Parliamentary Committee of Defence and Internal Affairs, which investigated the status of police land, yesterday presented its report to Parliament, indicating how Iranian development partners stand against Uganda police force and changed the ownership of the hospital from public-private partnership to a private limited liability company incorporated 15th of March 2018. The two Iranian nationals, Shahram Porojahani and Karim Ali, own 98% and 2% shares in the hospital, leaving police with nothing in the joint venture. The committee discovered that, although a consensus was reached that the Iranian would deregister the company as a private limited liability company, nothing has taken place.
Of the courtesies it had extended to the hospital, namely the ambulance, fuel, and payment of utility bills, noting that it was legally not tenable to continue spending government resources on a privately owned entity. In addition, the change of ownership caused a stalemate in the hospital's management to the extent that no board meeting has been held since October 2018. Right, Honourable Speaker, following this discovery, engagements with affected parties were initiated, lending to a consensus that the Iranian side deregisters the company as a private limited liability company and returns to the spirit of the MOU before any constructive engagements could be made on the way forward.
The Uganda police force entered a memorandum of understanding with Iranians to set up a hospital at its headquarters in Naguru. The memorandum of understanding was to provide subsidized specialized medical treatment to police officers and in return for land on which the hospital is sitting, free electricity, water, fueling the hospital generator, and an ambulance. However, all these clauses in the memorandum of understanding were not honored by the Iran-Uganda hospital. Instead, the hospital continued charging the police officers like any other private hospital.
Uganda Police Force and the Ministry of Foreign Affairs reported that whereas the project was to be established for the people of Uganda based on a public-private strategy, currently known as public-private partnership, in 2020, Uganda Police Force discovered that their Iranian counterparts had registered the project as a private limited liability company, wherein two Iranians owned 98% and 2% shares respectively, without the knowledge of Uganda Police Force.
Parliament recommended that individuals involved in the fraudulent transfer of ownership of the hospital be prosecuted. Parliament further asked police to engage the hospital management to develop new guidelines of the memorandum of understanding. Report compiled by Fred Kajubi for the news.